Namo Om Vishnu Padaya Krishna Prasthaya Buddhale Srimati Bhakti Vedanta Swami Tanamane Namaste Saraswati Devi Gauravani Pacharine Nivishesha Shunyavari Paskacha Deshitarine Srila Prabhupada Ki Jai. So, I was just listening the other day to a lecture by Srila Prabhupada, and he's describing the disappearance of Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Maharaj, his spiritual master. And what Srila Prabhupada said was very interesting. He said to the effect that who knew that he would become the disciple of Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur. And so in the same way, who knew that we would all meet Srila Prabhupada and come in contact with Srila Prabhupada through the Krishna consciousness movement? And it was in a lecture in Mayapur, I think the year was 74 or 75, where Srila Prabhupada stated that you are all joining me in this Krishna consciousness movement because in your previous life you were associated with Lord Chaitanya's Sankirtan movement. And Lord Chaitanya has placed you in different parts of the world so that you could continue your service to the Krishna consciousness movement. And so, who knew that we would all come together, just like Hari Sori Prabhu and I, we first came together about 45 years ago in Australia. Who knew that we would come together? Who knew that we would be together again today? Who knew, or who will know, when we will meet again? Because we have all, as devotees, we are all part of Srila Prabhupada's family. We have all been with Lord Chaitanya's Sankirtan movement in the past. We are with Lord Chaitanya's Sankirtan movement in the present. And we will again be with Lord Chaitanya's Sankirtan movement in the future. So it will not end here. And how we will meet again and the circumstances and what planet will be very interesting. Who knew? Who can know? Krishna can reveal, of course. So, Srila Prabhupada, when he left, each and every one of his disciples experienced simultaneously a great sorrow and also a simultaneous jubilation. It's a very interesting part of our culture is that when a devotee leaves his body, that we hold a festival to celebrate it. In Western culture, nobody has a celebration when somebody dies. They simply lament. So when a spiritual personality departs, we simultaneously lament their separation and we simultaneously celebrate their victory in leaving their body in Krishna consciousness. Just like one of our dear God brothers left his body this morning, Chaitanya Singh. And so it was actually a very glorious occasion to leave one's body in the holy dham of Sridham Mayapur. So we feel tremendous separation from Srila Prabhupada. And there is one place where Prabhupada describes that a disciple should weep, should even cry at feeling the separation. And many Prabhupada disciples did cry. But at the same time, how do you reconcile that crying with celebration? This is the nature of spiritual life. Because we don't want to see a devotee in a body which is incapacitated to the extent that makes devotional service very difficult. So, I'll just recite one verse which glorifies Srila Prabhupada very nicely. It's a verse that I'm very fond of. I like to quote it regularly, which describes the glories of Srila Prabhupada. Tavakatam ritam tapta jivanam kavibir iditam kalma shashaham shavana mangalam shimadatatam bhuvi grinanti je buridajana. Tavakatam ritam. The words of Srila Prabhupada are mritam, nectar. Tavakata, his kata is mritam, nectar. Tapta jivanam, and it gives great relief to the living entities. Tapta jivanam. Kavibir iditam, all the authorities have declared this. Kalama shashaham, such hearing of the words of Srila Prabhupada, Kalama shashaham, immediately destroy all sinful reactions to nil. Kalama shashaham. Shravana mangalam, very auspicious sound vibration. Srimadatatam. Srimadatatam means great, possesses great spiritual power. The words of Srila Prabhupada undoubtedly possess great spiritual power. So in that way, we're never separated from Srila Prabhupada. Bhuvi grinantije, that such great personalities, they sing the glories all over the world, as Srila Prabhupada did. Bhuvi grinantije, buridajana. So such great personalities are described as burida. Burida means most munificent. This word burida, munificent, is a word that is described predominantly in relationship with Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. But it is also just as applicable to Srila Prabhupada. Burida jana, most merciful personality. So, on the occasion of his disappearance, we are never separated from Srila Prabhupada. He is always present in his instructions. And to the degree that we follow his instructions, to that degree we are connected with Srila Prabhupada. Srila Prabhupada ki jaya.